set by? You tape speed.
Well, Jim, nice to see you.
Same here.
Been a while, but I'm glad you're back here with As Good As It Gets, most politically incorrect movie I've seen in years, but I love it. I love it. How many turndowns did you get before you were able to get this on the screen?
It was a rolling turndown. It was a check in the mail turndown where they kept on saying that next week they'd say okay, and the next week came and they wouldn't say okay, and that went on for the better part, well, for a little more than a year, and it got very frustrating. This is not the kind of picture that they can, they killed us with kindness, and they started to think, you start worried when somebody tells you what a special picture it is. No, it's a common picture, I swear to God. Nothing special about us, please.
Well, how many different studios looked at it?
Just one.
Oh.
But the people changed at the studio periodically.
They do that.
Yes.
So when
they finally gave me the go-ahead, the group that was there and the group that is there now, and Mark Canton was the head, and then John Kelly came in, and Lucy Fisher has been there throughout, as has Gareth Wick, and these are people who have been very important and very supportive, and it needed it. This picture needed friends like that.
When they finally said okay, did they also say, but you can't do this and you can't do that, you got to change this, you got to change
that? No, they never did that. There was never anything like that. This is the one thing they did. There was an actress that I wanted, that I had in mind for the part of Carol, and that I wanted very much, and she was asking for more money than they wanted to pay her, and she would not budge and they would not budge, and I didn't know what to do, and they said, at least see other actresses, at least see that. And I was concerned that the money issue would happen the way it was, because that several of us had cut their fees and to get this picture made. So this, it was a different spirit. So I started to see other people, and that's how I met Helen Hunt, and who was too young for the part, and who had a day job doing a series, which made the scheduling impossible, and then became the person you'd walk through fire to get for your movie.
I don't see how you could have improved on her. She's
marvelous. Not only her, and I mean this so much, Bobby, that if any of the first four characters had been played by other actors, I think it would have been hard to get to first base with the picture.
I cannot imagine anybody but Jack Nicholson getting by with some of the stuff he says.
Yes, 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 yes.
I mean, lines like Simon the Fag, Jews are at my table, think white. I mean, come on. I mean, do you have any fear that you're going to get a backlash from minorities?
No, it's been very different. One of our producers is gay, and one of the heads of the studio is, and it's been very different. When we did the trailer for this picture, and it was very important for our trailer to work, to say the word fag, and they have a rule against saying the word fag in a trailer, and they said because it's offensive, and we said, you're a straight organization with straight people talking to us, presuming to say what's offensive to gay people, why don't you ask them before you say no? And then they asked them, and I'm going to use a rough word right now, you'll tell me if I have to rephrase it. So Chastity Bono came in, who's head of the Gay and Liberation Task Force, and she looked at the picture and looked at the trailer, and she said, no, it's so clear that Melvin is an equal opportunity asshole.
Yeah, we have to clean that up. I don't think NBC is going to let me get by with it. We have a code, too. But
anyway, Chastity Bono did come in, and she did find nothing wrong with it, nothing offensive about it, and there hasn't been one complaint, not one. The trailer has been playing in thousands of theaters for a while, and I think that's the way it's going to go, because I think people understand what we're doing.
Did Jack object to any lines, and did you, compromise any lines?
He objected to one line, and I went, one line, here's the line, and what I'm going to tell you is a true story. So there's a line where he talks about how he imagines people with simpler lives and better lives and blessed lives live. And he talks about people who go to on boats, and these people who have picnics and they have a noodle salad. He didn't want to say noodle salad. He didn't know what noodle salad was. He wanted to say noodle pudding. To me, noodle pudding is kugel, that it's just I'm Jewish and that's a Jewish delicacy. This was about the great, WASP picnic kind of experience. And I remember yelling, I'm doing this picture so I could say noodle salad. And he asked the crew, he started to ask the crew, that the son of a gun actually had a plebiscite against me, saying, did you ever hear of noodle salad? Did you ever hear of noodle salad? And he said noodle pudding. And it bothered me so much. And then I spoke to my friends, you know, I spoke to some writer friends. I spoke to Cameron Crowe, who I'd worked with. And I spoke with a writer friend of mine in New York, and they say, you're not crazy. It is so different. You must say noodle salad. Now I had on film, and I just managed to put up a backdrop and go back and get noodle salad said in answer to your question.
I can see you now looping somebody else's voice. Jim, they're pulling the plug on us.
What?
I'm sorry, we're right down.
You have tape?